Whoa, Barbie, you got a nice butt. What'd I say? Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, hi, hello, my name is Kim. I go by Kimber Kiss Cosmic Queen here on YouTube, also known as Kimber Kiss. How is everyone? We're gonna film a twin flame reading. And it's Barbie themed today, obviously. So I'm using Fire Witch Tarot's Dolly Babe deck, which I absolutely love. And I'm excited to film this reading for you. Okay, let's get into it. I hope everyone's doing really good. Yeah, this is going to be a fun reading. I'm excited. Let's give these a nice little shuffle. How is everyone doing? I hope everyone's doing very, very well. Please hit that like button as you come in. Definitely subscribe because we have so much fun here. And oh my lord, today, anything is possible. Where there's Kim magic, there's Barbie magic. Let's get into this. Twin flame reading, all seriousness now. Checking him out. Oh, divine feminines. You are checking your divine masculines out. You're checking him out. You're checking him out. Look at that rose pink colored. The rose, what do they call them? Rose tinted shades. They're pink tinted shades. You're checking him out. Checking him out. And he's saying, fuck, I miss her. Look at him. I love this deck. Fuck, I miss her. He's saying, fuck, I miss her. Okay. This is a collective reading, okay? Barbie themed right here. In all seriousness, we're getting into this. Then I'm going to pull Divine Masculine and then Divine Feminine. And there's a treat coming up for you guys and gals. Just wait. Okay. So this says best friends, okay, but then look, the vibe ain't right, pull back. So this person might have friend zoned you and you're just like, fuck this vibe just ain't right. I'm pulling back. Okay, hold on. Then you're like, I deserve better. And look, she's wearing her tiara, her crown. She's like, I deserve better because I'm a queen, okay? I deserve better. And then she's like, oh, but it's okay. I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm fine. Look at me. I'm sitting on my ass, but hey, at least I got my high heels on. I'm fine. I'm fine. And I think this masculine, he's doing the same shit. He's like, fuck, I miss her. And then like 2 seconds later, he's like, oh, no, I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm fine. It's okay. I'm fine. Ooh, what's that card? Does that card want to come out? Oh, karmic shit. Look. So this person, he might have friend zoned you, or she might have friend zoned you, and you're like, fuck, it's hard to get out of this. You're feeling like stuck as fuck, like trapped, because they friend zoned you. They put you in that friend zone. You're like, this is hard to get out of this. Let's see what else we got. Okay, so yeah, this person, this masculine, he's like, fuck, I miss her. And he's hiding all this pain. He's hiding this pain. He really does miss you. Like 1 second, he's like, fuck, I miss her. And then another second, he's like, I'm fine. And then he's like hiding pain. And I think you might both be, you know, because of all this complicatedness. Let's see what else we got going on. So you feel like this person left you hanging. You're hanging. You're hanging here by a very thin thread. And then we have trying to heal. And then you're like, I'm at my best without you, actually. I'm at my best without you. But you're still healing. So it's like these back and forth emotions that you both are experiencing here. Divine feminine, divine masculine. Yeah, when the vibe ain't right, you pull it back and then you're trying to heal. And then when this person leaves you hanging, you're like, actually, I'm already good without you. But then you're like missing them 2 seconds later. It's so funny. Let's see what else we got. Oh, shit. Okay, she's like, just stop. And she's like, I'm this close to losing my shit. Like, just stop because I'm this close to losing my shit. Like, legitimately, that's what it says. I'm this close to losing my shit. So just stop. I'm this close to losing my shit. You could be dealing with a Capricorn that is driving you fucking off the rails. And this could be divine feminine, divine masculine. This is just collective here. But you're like, yeah, you're like, just stop it. I'm this close to fucking losing my shit. And this fucking Capricorn is driving me off the fucking rails. I can't fucking deal. This could be a karmic, this Capricorn. Let's see what else. Could be your twin, but yeah, you. Okay. You're like, I'm too smart for this bullshit. I'm too smart for this shit. I'm too smart for this bullshit. But I can't function. Like, I feel like I'm losing my limbs. I feel like I'm falling apart. I can't function. I just can't. This person could also be a Scorpio. Okay. Could be dealing with a Scorpio. But you're like, I'm too smart for this shit. When this Scorpio comes around me, I can't motherfucking function. That's why you're like, just stop. I'm this close to losing my other leg and both of my arms and my eyeballs and my brains, okay? Let's see. Fucking at it. Look, shut him up right now. Shut him up. Just stop. Just shut up. Just shut him up. Shut him up. I think this is the karmic they're talking about. Like, you're like, shut him up. Oh, I get it. I see. Well, it's like what I said at first, but his head is literally between her legs. Okay, so yeah, you're like, I'm just gonna get him to shut up right now. I'd be like that. Oh, I can't. Okay, these cards are hilarious. All right, let's see what else we get. I can't breathe. Okay, and that's why you say, like, I can't breathe. And you're like, I'm shutting you up. Okay, hang around still. And there's a frog. So, yeah. Hanging around still. There's definitely, I feel like it's this karmic. I feel like this karmic is driving you utterly insane and they just won't leave you alone. And you're just like, get the fuck away. And maybe this is you like hanging around your twin after he friend zoned you, but you're still hanging around. Like, what's up? If you friend zone this person, they're still hanging around. Unfortunately. Unfortunately. Okay, let's see. Crying. Aw. What just flew out? Broken. Oh my god. Reiterated. Yeah. This person feels like they're falling apart. Crying and broken. They're crying and they're feeling broken. That's sad. That's sad. Let's see what else we get. What other messages can we get here, Spirit? I don't know what this means. Acting sus? What does sus mean? I have no idea what this means. We're just gonna go with it. I don't know what that means. If anyone knows what that means, can you leave me a comment down below? So I really don't know what that means. Suspicious, acting suspicious. Acting suspicious, I figured it out. They're acting suspicious. I looked at her face and I was like, huh, she looks suspicious. And I'm like, oh, suspicious. Acting, this person's acting suspicious. And you're onto it. You're like, hey, don't play games with me. I'm fucking all knowing, bitch. Oh, what's this card? You might need to tell a white lie. Ooh. You might need to tell a white lie, or you're picking up on this white lie and you're like, this person's acting suspicious. Ooh. Drama mama in the Bahama by a llama. I don't know what I'm saying. Sorry. I don't know what I'm saying. Let's see what else we get. Aquarius. This person could also be an Aquarius or an air sign. Jeez. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I feel like you're releasing yourself from some sort of situation. I'm hoping it's karmic for y'all. I'm hoping you're getting out of some sort of karmic situation. But you're like, look at you. You got your hair did. You dyed it a really cool color. It's purple here. You're going on your own path and you got your arms raised. You're like, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Out of that fucking situation. So I feel like this is definitely like karmic that you're getting yourself out of. So that's really good. That's promising. Okay. So we're going to pull Divine Feminine and then Divine Masculine. And then we're also going to pull his thoughts and like what he's thinking but not saying and all of that. I love this deck, by the way. If you love it too as much as I do, check out Fire Witch Tarot. I absolutely love her in her reading. She's hilarious and amazing. And her decks are beautiful. And I love this one. I cherish it very much so. Going back in my pink bag here. I had to get it, you know, like all my Barbie skits. Only makes sense. Okay, let's pull feminine and then we'll pull divine masculine. Train's gone. This is gonna be good. I can feel it. Reward, ace of gems, first card for divine feminines. Holy shit. You're going towards something awesome. You're getting yourself out of some sort of shit. Because we saw the train, we saw the chains. That song came through today too, the chain song. Yeah, you're getting yourself out of chains and you're going, yeah, you're learning how to come into your own strength. Your strength is your reward here. Your strength is most definitely your reward and you're understanding your own strength. You're understanding your strength. So yep, you're learning it here. You're learning your own strength and you're coming into it. You're learning how to utilize it, how to work with it, how to manage it, how to make it work for you. Princess shells, so you can go towards this charmer, this prince, your princess shells. I feel like you put out a call, they put out a call. Now the calls have to be matched. They have to be lined up. There's a conch shell here, another conch shell there. The charmer. Yeah, you sacrifice a lot for this person. We have eight of shells, sacrifice in the reverse. Sacrifice a lot for this person. Gave up a lot of things. You went through a lot of sorrow, both of you. Both of you went through a lot of sorrow to try to get balance, to try to heal so you could come towards one another. Yes. So this strength that you are finding within yourself that is your ultimate reward is going to help you in your profession. So whether you have your own business or you're going towards a business, you anchoring and cultivating and learning and understanding your own inner strengths versus your weaknesses and making your weaknesses your own strengths is going to help you here in this process, Divine Feminines. Especially when it comes to career too, and this person that you're going towards. Any other messages here for Divine Feminines? Okay, they're not having me pull anything else for Divine Feminines. So we're gonna take a little break and then we'll get into Divine Masculine, what they're doing and thinking, but not necessarily saying. So here's our little break. Enjoy, get a snack, get a coffee, and then come back. But do you enjoy the entertainment? Oh, here it is, right here. Hope you guys enjoyed that. All right, we're gonna get into Divine Masculine. You know, I gotta have fun on my channel, and if you have not subscribed, now would be the time to do so, because it's gonna get even better. Okay, let's see. All right, Divine Masculine, what am I getting for you? Work. Yeah, this person's really focused on their work and bringing balance to this. And also like figuring out what they want to do for their profession. They have to understand they are protected. They felt a lot of disappointment and a lot of joy when it comes to, you know, work and seeing things that they want to do versus things they don't want to do. 10 is all about completions, new beginnings. 6 is about bringing balance to this. And 5 is a change. So coming out of disappointment when it comes to work to go towards joy. Yeah. And even though they felt like all this disappointment energy surrounding their job and career, it's letting them know that they've been protected this whole time and they had to figure out what they didn't want so that that way they could go towards what they actually do want in many areas of their life, not just work, but work was a huge one here that's being reiterated. Success, yep, they're moving towards success. They're moving towards success. This is so exciting. 10 of shells. Yep. 10-10. We have a 10-10 portal. This is all about completions, new beginnings. Coming out of the disappointed energy to go into success, something that they'll be very successful at. I feel like this will have to do probably with tapping into their intuition and spirituality and things of that nature. Maybe they're going to be tarot card readers. Maybe they're going to be healers. Maybe they're going to just simply be, well known in the spiritual community. But that's what I feel. Luck is on their side, and also with romance. Oh my God. Bottom of the deck is romance. Luck flew out with the Wheel of Fortune. Holy shit. Another 10, 10, 10, 10. A balance. So when they go through this completion and new beginning, it's going to feel kind of smooth. It's going to feel like a relief to them, to these divine masculines, because it's something that they've wanted all along. There was so much disappointment when it came into romance or in their current relationship, if they're with a karmic, but they're moving towards joy here. Luck and joy coming out of disappointment when it comes to the romance and the field of romance, and going into luck and joy when it comes to this romance. And look, this is the message. They're doubting it. They're doubting the message even as I'm saying it right now. They're fucking doubting it. But they have to understand that these doubts in their mind are simply illusions. They've sacrificed a lot, and all of this taught them a lot. That taught them how to be passionate, what it is they're passionate about. It helped them to transform. You helped to motivate this person and to change their attitude. And now they're seeing that, you know, maybe they can change like you. They can change like you did. And now they're building themselves back up towards the fulfillment. They'll have victory in this, reiterated. They're really obsessed with you. And they're kind of like a realistic mind here, because they like their independence. This is the truth. But they'll triumph over this because they want love. They want love. They want love. It's just off balance right now because they're not with the right person. They're not with you. They're not with their twin flame. So there will be celebration coming, even though they're doubting it. All it's going to take is a little bit of courage and a little bit of self-work on their own time to go towards this romance. But this is the challenge, and they're overcoming habits as well that is going to require them to have patience and to not be overgenerous with their energy either. They're learning how to not be overgenerous with their energy, and they're learning how to trust their own hermit phases, like their own introspections, why they had to go through stress, why they had to be an empath. And this is the message, okay? So that, see how fast that came through and how much it was, but it's like all in succession to go towards success. That's exactly what these energies are. All right, we're going to pull some of his thoughts, like what he's thinking and doing, not necessarily vocalizing, so that way we can have a better idea, and then I'll finish with a couple other cards. So this is the His Thoughts Mystical Flame deck by me. Look, upon splitting the deck, it's only you, and I wish things were simpler in the reverse. So they wish things were simpler because they know it's only you. And they said, please just leave him. Upon splitting the deck, please just leave him. So if you're with a karmic, they want you to leave. Okay, let's see. Whoa. I imagine what it'll be like to live with you. This is what they're imagining and thinking about right now as of late. You saw that, right? They're healing things. They're still healing things from their past. But they are imagining what it'd be like to live with you. I'm hearing lots of like motorcycles and like fast cars going by us. So this person might be into like fast cars, or wanting to get a new car or something, or a motorcycle, or maybe they already drive these things. I have a hard time opening up to you in the reverse. I have a hard time opening up to you. Okay. They're having a hard time admitting this to themselves as well. This connection is everything I've always wanted and more, and they're suppressing it. They're in denial, or they're suppressing it because they're in such a tight situation right now. I write you messages and then I get scared and I delete them on top of I'm healing things. So this might, the train just went. So that's a divine emphasis from spirit, meaning yes, this is true. They might have done this in the past, or they might just start doing it now because this is like coming out of the past going towards the future. So it might start happening where you notice that too, or you're doing that too. It could be for both sides, but I'm definitely getting that's what they're, trust me. This connection is everything I've always wanted and more. And even if this is in the reverse, you need to trust that this is how he feels. Trust me. This connection is everything I've always wanted and more. Trust me. That landed right on top of that card. Whoa, did you see that? I need nurturance. They really need your nurturance right now. This is in the reverse, which means they're probably not going to admit that they need your nurturance, but they do. Okay. All right, they want me to pull from, whoa, star seeds. Oh my gosh, I can't. I know, oh my God, we have star seeds. They wanted this card to come out. See how I almost dropped the whole deck? Star seeds. You are star seeds. If you were concerned or wondering, you definitely are. And I never knew what it felt like to fall in love till I met you. I never knew what it felt like to fall in love till I met you. Drop the mic. All right. We're going to pull some more cards here. This is the Romance Fairy Oracle by Cherry Enchantress, the mini version. Oh my God, you guys. Oh my God. Bottom of the deck. Holy shit. Bottom of the deck, look, bottom of the deck, twin flame union, heart, body, mind, and soul. I can't move right now. Twin flame union. All right, let's see. Let's get, I mean, you can't top that really. Psychic connection. Your communication goes beyond mere words. Holy shit. Holy shift. Can I get another card? Whoa, okay. Twin flame union just flew out. Twin flame union just flew out at the top, at the head of the reading. We have a healing connection. This is your romance will transform your life. It's really going to help you to heal. We have self-love first. Okay, love yourself first, then tease. The energy is fun and lighthearted, but uncertain. And then we have natural evolution here. Let the situation unfold naturally through to psychic connection all the way up to twin flame union here, which is literally at the top. And work with amethyst, Lemurian quartz, and shungite to ground your energy. That will really help all of you. Thank you so much for watching today. Thank you for all the new subscribers. Thank you for just having fun with me and channeling into all these energies. I love you all so really much. If you would like to share this video, tap the little share button with the arrow down below, copy the link, text it, DM it, or email it to 5 friends or family members or anyone going through a twin flame journey that could benefit from the entertainment today and the messages, or anyone that you think just needs a laugh, because come on. It's fun over here. Definitely subscribe. We have so much fun. I look at you as actual people, not subscribers, as actual friends and soul family members. I appreciate every single one of you. I really, truly do from the bottom of my heart. I love you. Thank you so much. Stay strong. We got this. Twin flame union is a coming. It's a coming. I feel it. I know it. I see it. I know it. I feel it. I know it. I love y'all so much. And until next time, guys and gals, I'll talk to you soon. Bye now.